fucking me up sometimes, bro. When I come a little bit one day, a little bit off my square, that should scare you a little bit, bro. Mm.
You got the remote, huh?
Man, let's watch some shit. I'm off of the sandwich over the head, man.
You said the sandwich?
Yeah.
I need to tell you my shit.
Man, I thought you sprayed some blunt spray on your hand.
Nah, this some hand sanitizer. Mm-hmm.
You had watched that damn on what's my name?
What? I know some that you did put me on though. I fuck with hard.
What that, bro?
The Boys.
Mm-hmm.
Why?
That's just savage right
seen,
now.
I done seen both seasons.
Yeah. They ain't got why. They don't hold back nothing, bro.
Mm-mm.
At all. What that was now?
What?
In that plan.
Michael Jackson? I don't know.
Oh, that's just some shit that came on?
That just came on.
Mm-hmm. Yo, we just gonna play some shit, see what's going on, bro. That shit that hard.
That car?
Mm-hmm, the gym, the new gym. That shit dope as hell. That shit nice as hell.
That's Nike goddamn headquarters.
For real?
Yeah, that was
he said. Driving, bro?
Probably a concept car.
God damn. The idea when you got that money, how you can go play ball with KD randomly.
They signed to Nike. They associates.
Mmm. You think this nigga the best artist?
Who?
Drake.
Hell yeah.
Easily?
Yes.
Yeah. I mean, like, all around.
That's why I said yes.
Man.
Like, he grabbed people, bro.
What you think it is, bro?
Shit.
That nigga crying on the video.
He ain't too hard. He ain't too hard, but he ain't too soft.
He know how to be himself. That's what you're saying.
Yep.
He ain't afraid to be himself. That shit kind of hard, though.
To be yourself?
For some motherfuckers.
Lay your heart.
You know.
Relax.
I ain't need no bros in this video. Them nigga went back with the throwback video. Mm-hmm. Jet skin and shit, nigga. That shit do be fun though, bro.
What?
And jet skin?
I ain't never been.
Boy, me and Low went, rest in peace, but boy, Low, boy, me and Low went jet skiing in the floor.
Mm-hmm. I remember whenever you fell. Who mm-hmm. fell out for you
he
or him?
He did. He was about to drown. I'm all like, help
and
me.
The phone.
Mm-hmm. We had it all recorded. Oh. This nigga done got hit stick by the beast, nigga.
You ain't never seen
that? I ain't never seen this video, bro. Dang. That shit hard, bro. It was a good goddamn video. Bro, they going crazy with the money. You see this shit?
In the Nike outlet.
Mm-hmm. Bro, when you get that money, you're going to go crazy like that, bro. You're going to have fun with the money, bro.
You here, bro? Why this video? This shit so crazy, like, it's funny how it end, though. Oh yeah, let me get you right. I got you, cause you ain't. That was this the funniest part of it. Nah, I'm
good. What did that nigga say?
This the funniest part of that shit.
Sure. And they got that.
Yes, sir, Dope Nation.
That nigga got his little 50 Cent moment.
He said he got a warrior spirit. No, you got tissue.
Nigga had a moment, bro. Uh-huh.
Hey, boy, listen.
Damn, that shit gotta be lovely, bro.
I'm in the trench, relax. That nigga went on.
Girl balling.
Who?
Took a girl shopping.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, that boy got a card. Nigga, a rapper got a card made, bro.
He got an NBA championship, too.
You right. Forgot about that. That shit crazy.
What you think about that Gucci on Jeezy?
I'm glad you had me there. I've been hearing niggas trying to take the high road. We're a little different than that.
You say nigga, what?
It's a little different than that with me, nigga. I'm old enough to
remember. What you that say? Shit. What you just said? What you said before? What was the initial word?
Niggas out here trying to take the high road and shit. Uh-huh. But nigga, I'm old enough to remember shit. Shit a little different than that for me, bro.
Mm-hmm.
That nigga Gucci was a fucked up nigga back in the day, bro.
Mm-hmm.
And niggas gonna act like, man, that was so long ago. They trying to grow out of that shit. Fuck, nigga, fuck you. You sent somebody to kill me, nigga.
In real life.
For real. Ain't no, we going to beat them. They, man, they was going to do that nigga ass. Bruh.
That's why it cool how Gucci reacted whenever you think about it.
Nigga, it was always going to be that, my nigga. I don't know what niggas thought was going to happen. These niggas got real history. Like,
mm-hmm.
I understand, like, it was a good look for Atlanta and for the rap culture.
Mm-hmm.
But that nigga Jeezy needed to hear that shit, bro, at the least. My nigga, you sent some nigga to kill me.
Yeah.
Now, Gucci was a savage. He was like, boy, I killed them nigga. Mm-hmm. Boy. Fuck, send some more, I'm going to kill them too. You know what mm-hmm. I mean? Type of deal.
Mm-hmm.
But he should have heard that shit, bro. Yep. Nigga, you were wrong. Niggas out here talking about, oh, man, shouts out to Jeezy because nigga, you know, he taking the high road out here now, nigga. That nigga's a fucking, was a goddamn thug nigga in the streets. You know what I mean? So it was thug ass activity.
He said to hit it. Well, we don't know if he said they hit out. But
everybody know the deal with that, bro.
The crazy thing about it is
that was a nigga homeboy, bro.
Yeah, boy.
Nigga know what the deal was for real with that shit.
You think they cooking good too, Dope Nation.
That damn Subway good.
Mm-hmm.
That the
first one.
Hell no, nah, that's the second one, nigga. That first one gone. That's why I don't get this shit like that. I eat that shit so fast.
Yeah.
Nigga, I ate this shit about halfway through the Drake video. My nigga, that first one was out there. That shit was gone, nigga. I was watching that shit dreaming about me having the money like that, nigga. Like, yeah.
You think they fuck with each other now, though? You think they'll do music?
I mean, it's a smart power move, because really, niggas don't want to hear what they got to say. But it ain't that hard to believe they'll do it now, because niggas don't even have to be in the same room to do music no more.
They don't.
Not even in the same state, so.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
I'm just singing a song.
Yeah. Like, I heard niggas, though, they were like, damn. They were really more pissed off that Gucci didn't get back, Jeezy didn't say nothing back to defend his folk. Okay, he didn't want something to get him killed.
He can't say nothing, though.
He can. You gotta say something.
No, he can't say nothing.
It'll incriminate him.
Mm-hmm. What the fuck is incriminate?
I don't think what the nigga said. Yeah, nigga, you better shut the fuck up while I send some more. You know what I mean? But that would incriminate him.
What the fuck is incriminate?
Nigga, whatever the word I'm trying to use, nigga. Incriminate, bro. You know what I'm saying? The wrong dog.
I might get heat because you got food in my house until you get done chewing.
Incriminate.
What?
I'm still
chewing.
The wrong.
Stop chewing, bro.
Incriminate. What's the word, my dude? Yeah. Bro, what's the word, bro?
Huh?
The word I'm trying to use, bro. You know, incriminate. Nigga, that's a real word, nigga.
All right, we'll go with it.
I think it is.
Yeah,
right?
I mean, shit, if you want it to be.
My nigga, that's what it is, incriminate, when you tell on your goddamn self, right?
When you be doing what?
Tell on your goddamn self. Then you gonna make me Google it in a few minutes.
Ask Siri. Damn, yeah.
Ask Siri.
Ask Google.
I'm gonna add Google, nigga. I ain't got Siri, nigga.
You ain't got Siri.
What does incriminate mean? This nigga think I'm retarded, though, nice. Here we go, right here. Google stupid as hell. Come on. Indigo. What does incriminate mean? Incriminate.
Make someone appear guilty of a crime or wrongdoing. Strongly imply the guilt of someone.
Yeah.
Okay. All right, so the word
that
is.
That was funny.
The what word is incriminate. Incriminate. I was saying incriminate.
That was funny.
Oh, shit. Well, yeah, so. A nigga would incriminate himself, you know what I'm saying?
He would incriminate
himself. Yeah, and fuck it, right here, what it is. This eye show moment right now, right? Nigga would incriminate himself, you know what I'm saying? So, he really couldn't say too much, but he should have said something.
What? I don't understand. What?
Like, watch a goddamn Marvel song, you know what I mean? Because that nigga really bossed up on G's ass. Like, nigga, I'm a street digger, that's what it is, like, but I'm a boss, nigga. Like, nigga, I mean, I don't even know why. Motherfucker got mad at Gucci. Everybody know Jeezy got more hits than Gucci. Easy. Popular hits. So it ain't really nothing was there about that. I just think it was really.
So who won the battle to you?
Musically? All right, we got. I'm going to give it to Gucci. Because to me, Gucci stood up there like a real one. You feel me? And we going on that. Because that nigga was rapping that goddamn true. He was looking dead at that nigga. I was like, why, please go over there and just slap his ass. I like this shit. Why, that shit was tense. You know what I'm saying? But yeah, he owed him one, bro.
Your mama's Jeezy one looking at him.
Mm-hmm.
He had his head down.
Because nigga don't like to see the truth, bro. That was that truth. That nigga was telling no lie, bro. But as far as music, man, no doubt. Jeezy got more hits now.
Like, it was damn near 2 million people on that stream.
Mm-hmm.
You was on that IG? Yeah. You actually, we was in the same club then.
I was there, bro.
You was in there?
I was in there.
Damn.
That shit was crazy. That shit was crazy, but we were watching that shit at the house.
The power of the phone, though.
Yeah. That's wild, ain't
it? Yeah.
That shit is wild.
The app. Like, I wonder if the app shut. That shit didn't even crash the app.
No. Didn't.
Streaming is a motherfucker.
Kept going. But you know they made some money out there.
Hell yeah. All type of money. All type of money.
Had to. That's all it was. Nigga could have been like, yeah, all right, nigga, I'm going to see you later. But we finna get the bread right now, though.
Exactly.
You know what I mean?
They came out, they say, boy, this be some money right here. Me ain't got, because that's the first time people, because they beef so goddamn real because of that death.
They was able to play off that.
Yeah, they actually flipped that into a positive.
Now, the real thing is, that shit could have went sideways. I don't think them two niggas were going to do nothing. But, like, you got to think. Niggas like that, they got niggas up under them that'll really do something to you.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah, for no reason.
For nothing. You know what I mean? Just because they feel like you tried. You feel me? Like, okay, I got them. Don't worry about it. I got this shit. And go do something to one of them niggas. So I think they had to be careful about how they dealt with nothing.
Yeah.
You know, because that shit could have sparked up something for real. Mm-hmm. Throughout Atlanta. You know what I mean? Like, for real. Like a real situation.
Gucci said, I had to keep it real.
Yeah, he said. That man tried to kill that.
The first song he came out with, though.
That shit was hard, bro.
That nigga came out this and then. That was a real battle, though.
Mm-hmm. He really felt that shit. And that wasn't no shit that he just made up. That shit he had out a long time ago. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
That shit got real history on it, bro.
Mm-hmm.
And that's just it, bro. But it kind of crazy, like, they just exploited that shit. That's all, man.
Yep.
The fact that them niggas in the same room together, you knew they weren't going to do nothing. Them niggas had agreement. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
So Gucci was just like, I'm just take the time to talk my shit to the nigga that I've been wanting to say. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
You can tell he been wanting to say that shit, how he was saying it, bro. There was some truth and passion behind that shit. Shit, and Jesus.
That nigga Jesus had to look like his PR people say, just take the high road, Jesus.
Yeah, they told him
that. Sit back, don't say nothing.
If you say something, nigga, everybody gonna know you tried to really kill this man. Now you confirming it. So it like, shit, what you gonna do? He had to take that. You feel me?
And then Jesus told his ass, Gucci, I got him $10,000 coat.
He was capping. Talking about he got him half that long.
Yeah, when he said he don't have, you think he was capping on that?
I said they did research on it. He was capping. You know the internet motherfucker be looking shit up, bro.
I don't have that long.
Them internet motherfuckers ate that shit up. And maybe he own more than what he's saying on that. You feel me?
What they say he own?
About 5 or 6, bro.
I mean, shit. You know nigga be over-exaggerating. That's a lot, though, in Atlanta.
It is. I mean, that money, it costs something. Believe it, bro.
That's a lot.
Yeah, that's a lot.
5 properties, shit. That half of Atlanta to me.
It is. You give them that.
Well, hell yeah. Atlanta ain't really number that big.
When you really look at it for real, coming from nigga in Atlanta, I get
that. Yeah, like Atlanta number did big.
The more motherfucker nigga think this shit big as a motherfucker.
But other people owned in different entities. If he owned 5 in this area, shit. In a percentage game, that shit might be half.
When you really look at the real Atlanta.
Yeah.
Not no goddamn outskirts city. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
It makes sense if you look at
hell
it.
Hell
like
yeah.
That. Atlanta really ain't that big.
Hell no. He might do.
That's why I really feel this shit was just really just a money grab anyway.
Yeah, that was a money
if
grab.
If niggas really want to see each other in Atlanta,
Jesus
really
dropped
a nigga in Atlanta,
yeah,
bro.
Jesus dropped the album, bro.
That's the next right day. There. He promoted it right there.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. More definitely.
Like, why not?
Yeah.
It's damn new. That's 2 million people watching.
Half a month
at one time, bro. Do you know that people got streams? Like, you know what I'm saying? All them streams that was on them, like, mean it was two. It was this music they playing in the background. That shit is like If it was a million people on there, that's a million streams.
I heard that shit. Oh, they counting that too with
Blank? Yes.
Oh, man.
Like, yes.
Man.
That's a million streams.
That's cold, bro. That's cold, for real.
Like, they showed
that's
a lot of love to people.
Yeah. I mean, it most definitely made both of them real.
You know, I'm just talking about the other artists they were playing at the beginning.
Oh, yeah. I caught it like 10 minutes in. I made the very, very beginning.
Look, Gucci, yeah, he tried to goddamn. See, he tried to go.
It back on that nigga.
He like, he trying to take the high road. Like, yeah, nigga. This shit slick funny when you think about it. He's like, hey, I'm mature over here. Fuck you.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, like, nigga, fuck you, nigga.
Yeah, but look. Yeah, but here I stand, the grown ass man.
Yeah. But then it like,
nigga
then
trying,
nigga
to,
trying
pop
to play the grown man role.
Yeah.
But Gucci like, nah, nigga, fuck you, nigga. Mm-hmm. We still the same nigga. We just got money now. Mm-hmm. Don't think it, like. But yeah. It good. I'm glad ain't nothing happened. Don't get me wrong. But I ain't promoting that shit, like, for violence or anything.
Yeah.
But that's just like a nigga, I do something to you. Mm-hmm. A couple years down the road. Shit, I done forgot about that shit, mm-hmm. right?
Because it didn't affect you. It didn't affect
me like that. It might have caught me a little something. You know what I mean? But Nick can't take your life. You had to catch a body. Mm-hmm. You feel me? Maybe you ain't want to kill nobody in life, bro. You know what I'm saying? You wanted to keep your hand blood free and possible. Yep. And then nigga put you in a situation where you had to kill a nigga, bro. That shit changed your life.
Yeah.
When you do some shit like that, that just ain't no everyday type shit that you can just forget about. Nah, nigga, you had to off a nigga, bro.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
That nigga, that was a real thing.
Yeah, that nigga got down.
I think Gucci needed to let that out, though. I think now he probably feel better about it.
Yeah,
now he got to say, fuck you, nigga, in the face. Like, you know what I'm saying? Nigga, this why. You know what I mean? This why I'm mad. Nigga, this why. Tell the world.
Yeah. You shot at me.
People didn't know that shit, bro.
You don't think people knew that?
My Brittany didn't know what the fuck happened. She was like, what happened between them two? But she ain't from Atlanta.
I'm Brittany not from Atlanta?
No.
Okay, but yeah. But, damn, I ain't know.
You know, you got young people that listen to this shit now. They like, what the hell going on with them nigga? You know what I mean? Why that nigga? And some nigga, that nigga might look like a hater. You feel me? Gooch? You know what I mean? Like,
yep.
That nigga just talking bad about that nigga and shit. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. But real history, man. He
had, Gucci had to come out like that. If he didn't come out like that, it would have been like, damn, Gooch, that nigga tried to kill you.
Mm-hmm.
Cause Gucci said I hit my own mouth though that he tried to kill him.
Yeah, they did interviews and everything about that shit, bro. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
But that nigga though, nigga tried to be like, oh, that nigga Gucci dry snitching. But if you go back to Jesus song, that nigga had the hit on the end of the goddamn song.
What you mean?
He was like, yo, man, I got $10,000. Anybody bring me that nigga chain, man? You know Gucci gonna pay. You know what I'm saying? Oh, Jesus gonna pay. Hey, man, said that shit on the radio, bro. I wish I could remember the name of the goddamn song, man.
Damn.
Yeah. I done saw him directed the shouter though.
Yeah.
Man, that nigga knew what time it was.
He said, exactly, I wasn't doing it unless I could do me.
He knew exactly what was finna come out of that bottle, bro. He knew exactly what it was.
Gucci! I'm gonna do some clashing. I ain't never heard that shit.
Mm-hmm. That ain't how we play. They said that nigga son is the death threat.
Who?
That nigga Pookalo.
Who Pookalo?
That's a nigga Gucci kid. The one Jesus sent.
Who sung in the death threat though?
Pookie Long.
Why his son getting the death threat?
I don't know, man. Nigga just fucking. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Then it ain't easy. But somebody said something that was so real the other day.
What?
They were like, their music was different, but it was the same. You know what I mean?
What you mean?
It was all like hood nigga music. But it was like music in different states and elevation of the game. You know mm-hmm. what I mean? Like, Jesus made music for niggas that were probably like up. You feel
mm-hmm.
me? You know
mm-hmm.
what I'm saying? They were like mm-hmm. the, they were like the weight man. You feel me? Like he got put on. You know what I mean? Or he yeah, was at the stage yeah. and like where well, he was up. You feel me? He really ain't have a lot of music, but you know what I mean?
Struggle.
Like the trenches of
yeah.
it. You feel me? You know he they say like. Jesus was like a nigga that just used to ride up and down the highway with the work, you know what I'm saying, type of deal. Mm-hmm. Getting the big money plays, you know what I mean? And they were like, shit, when it came to Gucci, Gucci like got it out the mud type
yeah,
of nigga.
He
you know what I mean?
Like, he probably one of the niggas
line
that,
nigga.
He probably one nigga had in the apartment selling dope, little nickel dime
you know
starting off, like, then goddamn hustled it up.
Really,
a
really
bit.
Worked
yeah.
his way through the game and made something out of himself because
yeah.
You know what I mean? Yeah, nigga yeah. like that had to make. You know what I mean? You had to be a certain type of dude, bro.
Yeah. Because it's like Jesus took the damn express route. More high risk, though.
Man, it's all the same jail time.
Yeah,
it just
but
depends
his,
on where your mind say that, right?
Only reason I said more high risk, you outside with it.
I mean, shit, not really, because you in the trap with it. You know
yeah,
what I mean?
Yeah, but you know what coming around now. When
you
coming up
down
the road, yeah,
whenever
you do.
You got that shit in your car.
That's what I'm trying to tell you. Like, but I'm saying though, like, in the car, like, if you in your trap, like.
Are you saying it more worse in the trap than it is going up and down the highway?
I think it worked going up and down the highway with it. The trap, like you might have your enemies, but this your front. You goddamn, you got your security. You watching everything. You watching. You able to watch it. Not saying shit can't happen.
Mm-hmm.
But when you on that road, that's the unknown.
The only thing the bad part is about that is the goddamn, the ops is expected. You know what I mean? That come with the game.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? The shit that we're a trap nigga, I think it really the police, bro. So you in the trap, the police already know you though. You know what I mean? Especially if your trap hot.
Yeah.
You gonna need a little heat to get that motherfucker booming. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So it like shit, it come with it. Nigga, yeah. I'd rather be out on the road than to be in the trap with it though.
Yeah. I understand that because you could be low key.
Yeah, I mean, you got different moves. You just got to try to trick them niggas.
But
you know
that,
what I mean?
That shit, that car, that like be more time though. Because you taking high risk.
A lot of time.
But you taking high risk. Them niggas be.
A lot of but you right. The road man got to work. He got
yeah,
a lot
yeah,
of
yeah, because he getting it both ways. He getting it from the. Like, say if a work man on the road, a trafficker get caught. He responsible for that dope both ways.
Man, either you're going to have a lot of money
Listen,
or a lot of dope.
He responsible for that dope both ways. If he got goddamn 10 keys in the trunk, boom, he got pulled over. He got to explain to these folks that well, his dope. He responsible for paying for that, right? Even though, like, the cartel, whoever it is, they want their money.
If y'all had locked up, they probably got somebody in though. You know what I mean? So you got to look at it like that, too. Just because you go to jail don't mean the shit over with.
That's what I'm saying, though.
You know, so.
But that's what I'm saying about the difference between the trap.
I mean, it just depends on what your level of risk you want to take, really, bro.
Yeah, that shit is a high risk,
you
though,
know, all of it is.
Yeah.
You know, either you going
to I'm thinking you moving heavyweight. I'm thinking you moving, like, on it. When you trapping, you moving heavyweight.
Yeah, yeah.
Compared to, like, if you're in the trap, you might goddamn move, like, a couple pounds of weight. Or you know what I'm saying? You might goddamn.
I think it's more in the car because of the destinations you got to go to drop that shit off
mm-hmm.
at. You know what I'm saying? But, like you say, you could be low-key. You don't have to really deal with what the trout nigga dealing with.
Yeah.
You feel me? You just got to worry about them people on your ass. And every now and then, mm-hmm. somebody following your ass.
You know what I'm saying?
You know what I'm saying? But when you in that trap, bro, it like, nigga, you got to worry about the ops, robbing niggas, niggas in your crew, gonna kill your motherfucking ass, police more definitely, you know what I mean? So hating that other trout nigga that ain't getting money like you get. You know what I mean? Usually the nigga that's in the car don't nobody know.
Exactly.
You know what I mean?
That's the unknown. Like, you name all these people that you have to be aware of while you're in the trap.
Yeah.
That means your antenna's up for all of that shit.
Your antenna should be up for all this shit anyway.
Yeah, but
first
I'm saying.
First of all, that nigga, that shouldn't have been driving shit. You feel me? That's what's real.
What you
and
mean?
He the nigga that got to work.
Shit, yeah, he probably had that, but that was his shit.
He probably have been driving.
He
shit.
Probably had to get to that point though.
Well, then that's the difference. You know what I mean? That's a different story. That means you started off as transportation.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, that's why they take the most risk.
And that shit. And honestly, bro, they don't really get that much money for transportation, bro. You know what I mean? Unless you go and meet somebody, pick up your own shit, and you the weight man. But he do talk like in his rap, like he was the weight man. You feel me?
Yeah.
Cause you got niggas that don't even sell the dope. They don't even be there to wrap it up. Nigga just there to drive it, bro.
Yeah.
That's it. Drive it, drop it off, get the money, get back. And them usually be like lower key people in the world, bro. Like old folks and shit.
Yeah.
White folk, you know what I mean? Somebody you wouldn't even think.
Yeah.
Nigga have a geek squad stick on the side of his car. Isn't he about to smart, bro. Have a whole geek squad route car. Have nigga, if I was them nigga, boy, I got to have a Chick-fil-A truck made, just like the other Chick-fil-A truck, nigga.
What you mean?
Nigga, if I had to drop all dope in that Atlanta, nigga,
I'd
go get a Popular company. And I wrap my car in that same Popular company shit, bro.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? Like Chick-fil-A or the Red Bull, you know what I mean? You know what I'm saying? Or Chick-fil-A catering or some shit, you know what I mean? Something that don't look too bad.
Yeah.
So when you bring in all these fucking bags, it's like a catering charge, you know what I mean?
Damn.
Before that shit get hot, bro, that shit'll be over with. It'll be done, you know what I mean?
Damn,
at least you'll be on your way in the money before somebody catch on, unless somebody tell.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I just gave some niggas some points. And then, like, hey, bro, if y'all get that shit going, man, hey, look out for you, boy, man.
15%.
Shoot me a little cash app or something, man. I ain't tripping. Whatever on your heart, whatever move.
Cool,
you.
Tell it, send that cash out.
Whatever your heart move you to do, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But I be thinking about that, bro. I'm like, man, what if I was to ever goddamn, you know, do some shit like that, bro? First of all, you got to know the people like that.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? After you find that out, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, it levels to it.
Hey, man, you know. You know what, though? I've had opportunity because I'm in transportation anyway.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
They becoming a truck driver.
I mean, it's been opportunities presented. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? It's just up to you what you want to do. You know what I'm saying? I never really went with that shit. I was like, nah, bro, I'm cool. That ain't really what I want. You
that
know
ain't
what I mean?
Really my forte.
Because you got to think, a lot of them didn't get set up for the diamond.
What
you
mean?
Might be the nigga that they sent through there to get caught so the rest of the dope can come in. You know what I mean?
Damn, I ain't think about that.
Yeah, we got to get them niggas a little something, man. Them folk want, you know what I mean, what they want.
Yeah.
Goddamn, listen. Seeing Fat Boy through there, we got them about 20 bricks. Goddamn, when he get to that counter right there, they going to pull him over. Goddamn, when they pull him over, we're going to slide this other 200 through there. You know what I mean?
Damn.
Small donation.
And you got to take that goddamn.
County, you know
you
what I mean?
You got to take that goddamn
you
charge.
You taking that charge, nigga, because it's in your car, in your possession. You taking it. You know what I mean? They going to feel good. They going to take picture of the dope. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Probably have you in the newspaper and shit. Don't nobody read no goddamn newspaper no more. You going to be on the news and shit looking crazy.
And like you a real trap star. Mm-hmm. You really ain't. You the goofball.
You really
you the goofball.
Try to make you some money to pay your bill real quick.
You the goddamn pun in
you
that game.
You hit a sweet lick. Why you like, ooh, them boys going to give me $30,000 off that truck. Yes. Get your ass banged up, bro.
Damn, that crazy when you think about it.
Get your ass banged up, bro. I really never would. For it, bro. After my dad got caught, I was like, man, fuck this shit. Somebody told on that nigga, man.
Yeah.
So it's like, damn, ain't no loyalty in this shit, man.
Yeah.
Fuck that. Why they can all go to hell?
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Now that's stupid.
And that was probably like one of the greatest things about this, though, because like if people grew up loving Jeezy and Gucci, you know what I'm saying? Now you get to see them reconcile as like, I guess, grown men, even though they battled all the way to the end, till Gucci finally accepted the fact that he was going to call
troops.
Do you
think he found a level of acceptance and forgiveness, though?
I believe he don't give a damn no more. It was just like this shit right here, they had people watching. Shit, he dropped a compilation album, like,
Gucci.
Yeah, old hits.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Like, the next day, like, it's just like that. It's like about staying relevant. It's like creative ways to stay relevant
most
with
definitely.
The goddamn public.
Most definitely.
And this was a way they could do that shit and not have to coon out, basically, but coon out. They ain't have to stoop down low and really go against really what they they Mars they is the goddamn. Yeah, they handled it. Yeah, right. To try to get attention. You know what I'm saying?
Now, I did like that fact. It didn't seem like a thirst bucket attempt.
Exactly.
You know what I mean? Now, it was a good show, bro. I think Gucci made the show, though.
He did.
You know what I mean?
He did.
Like, because I thought that G's and T.I. were going to buy that first.
Yep, and
they were supposed to.
They were, and then
they dropped him and picked up Gucci, right? Pretty much something like that.
Yeah, I think T.I. finna battle Wayne in December.
For real?
Yeah. What you think about that?
Boy, the greatest rapper alive
against T.I.
against the King. I think Wayne might get him. Hey. Not relevant till the day hits. I think till Wayne more. Till this day, lately.
Okay.
Lately.
Okay.
Wayne was the nigga, bro, that Carter.
Oh, look.
The dedication, what was the dedication? Did it come out? Which one was it, man? That nigga was, Wayne was the shit back in the day.
Wayne was just a mood. Like, to me, he came whenever I was, like, at the end of my high school career. He was just a vibe. Wayne was, like, who niggas, like, the ensemble. He embodied what niggas wanted to be perceived as. Like, cool, dope, different. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Individual, bro. He had niggas out here like really in their bag of themselves. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Like,
he was a young nigga starting
too,
bro.
Yeah.
Young as fuck, bro.
I don't know how that one gonna go. It gonna probably be a homeboy reunion type of feel with them two.
It gonna be Wayne.
Wayne ain't gonna win it, but it gonna be like a homeboy type of feel. I wanna know who gonna do. I wonder if they gonna do more numbers though than Gucci and goddamn T.I. though.
Only one that really do more numbers and shit like this is goddamn R&B singers, bro. You know what I mean? They done been up there. You know what I'm saying?
They done been up there like 1.2.
They done been up 1.2 some. Brittany told me she sang song like 2 some.
Damn.
Yeah. So it like
so for hip hop, that was just half for hip hop.
Man, hell yeah, that was real good. That shit was up there, bro.
Damn.
You know. That's streaming on Instagram.
Yeah.
You know? That shit is great.
Amazing. Like, whenever they came over that whole platform,
you
gotta
think how
verses.
Many people wanted to get on there but couldn't get on there.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Like, that shit was amazing.
They created a demand with that verse.
Yeah, they did, bro. Nigga, they were people. I would call them folks. They were like, boy, hey, get on my phone, boy. I'm watching this shit. I'm like, watching. Oh, shit, that shit is on. Like, let me watch that shit.
Then you can get it from your phone.
Yeah, literally, right there. Boom. Motherfuckers on there. You can see motherfuckers on the internet reacting to that shit like, oh shit, man, this shit crazy. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I don't think nobody gonna do better than that as far as like rappers.
Yeah.
Cause that was a real situation.
The energy in that room probably was like goddamn crazy, electric.
Anything could happen. Like niggas could.
They got two different entourages.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying?
It could be. Somebody could really get the bucking in hell, you know what I mean? And it could be a real issue.
Yeah.
You know, so it's like, man, it could really go down at any time. So that shit probably would be tense for a minute, you know, besides listening to the music. Hell, then after that, they went to the club, so you know it wasn't no issue.
Yeah.
You know?
How you feel about him and the girl, his wife?
I think that's amazing, bro. I don't think nobody should be stuck in the box. You know what I mean? She know what that nigga is, bro.
She know
where she come from. That's his girl. That's his woman.
The little Asian girl?
Yeah, you know what I mean? She probably know everything about him and love him to death. You know, them little good girl be loving a bad boy, bro. Mm-hmm. You know?
She's straight too.
Yeah, she got her own situation going over there with the view shit and everything. Yeah. I think that dope as hell, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Why not?
Yeah.
I don't give a fuck about all that.
Yeah.
You know, black folks supposed to be with black folks shit, but I don't really give a fuck about that. That
people
don't
go make
a lot
happen.
Of people ain't gonna like me. I said that. But I don't really give a fuck, bro. It is what it is, dog.
People will get you happy.
Exactly, bro. Whatever make you happy, bro, do it. Shit, why the fuck am I worrying about your shit anyway, just being real?
And that, and
nigga, your
really,
relationship ain't gonna bring no joy to my life.
And nigga really don't no even give a neither. Damn either.
For real, I don't even it's get
it. People just talk about shit
bro.
For the goddamn topic, and that's why I brought it up.
That shit, bro, like, for real, when they ask me that, you feel like a black man should be with a black woman and a white girl should be with a white woman. Like, man, I don't give a fuck about that shit.
Mm-hmm.
Why the fuck is y'all worried about it? You know what I mean? That means your relationship ain't fulfilled like you want it to be. If something lacking in your shit, if you gotta worry about another motherfucker dating a white girl, you know what I mean? A black woman dating a white dude. You feel me? Like, Come on, man. Shit don't matter, man. Fuck that shit, bro. You either got good people or you got fucked up people, huh?
Yeah. There's a lot of motherfuckers that have fucked up.
Yeah. Stuck with the wrong motherfucker because they... I wanted to date my people. Keep it in my people, sir. Nigga, that might not have been the one for you. You know what I mean?
Could be horrible.
It could be absolute trash.
Garbicho.
High quality garbage, man. You know what I mean?
Dope Nation, we want to introduce you to Cracker Boy and Nigga Boy.
Hey, that is. That is, goddamn.
They're going to be coming soon.
I tell you, goddamn, that goddamn Nigga Jeezy. Goddamn was out there. I thought he was going to get his ass beat because goddamn Gucci Man was going to fuck him up with that goddamn truth song.
Shit, yeah, because real nigga going to do real shit. Jeezy goddamn shot at his ass, Cracker Boy.
I tell you though, man, I tell you. Ain't shit like goddamn, you know, going out and sending a hit on nigga ass. You know
shit,
what I mean?
Hell nah.
Down there
goddamn,
in the country.
Now that what happened though, you send a hit out on nigga, hit nigga goddamn in a flat
goddamn out there in the country
ass.
How we do. We're goddamn busher, goddamn man.
No, this ain't that.
Like
though.
My Uncle Keith West, he got drunk one night and got on his goddamn horse and went for a ride and tried to shoot a motherfucker.
God damn.
Yeah, man, that some bitch didn't play.
Hell nah, you gotta come up here to the city, go goddamn place like Perry, home, shit like that. Like when shit get real, letting goddamn Yinga Bay do that goddamn crap.
We don't fuck around with that shit, man. Y'all got roaches over there,
hey, man.
We got our own fucking problem, man. We got critters. Y'all got roaches. We got
critters.
Fucking critters,
what's the
man.
Fucking difference?
Fucking critters, man. We don't have shit in our fucking series. Our moms and dads stayed together, so we wouldn't have to experience that shit, boy.
Shit, that's why y'all got the shit, but y'all got them incest shit going on.
That shit is
now.
Great.
And y'all be fucking on each other.
That's how
now.
Come we start fucking so early. Yeah. We got them right there in the house with
right
us, man.
Right there. Fucking your sisters and your brothers.
That's all right, goddamn it. At least I ain't no goddamn virgin. Yeah. Hey, bro, I'd be fucked up with it, bro. I'd be fucked up, bro. Just having two goddamn negative ass opinions. I mean, it'd be good. It'd be funny, but just like if you can just get the absolute worst redneck ass white boy and the absolute worst just out there black dude and just bring them in the same room, but they like homeboy. But they just got from two different goddamn worlds. That'd be the best goddamn TV show ever, bro. You know what I'm saying? That would be the best
be
fucking
amazing.
TV show ever, dog. Like, I think everybody watch that shit.
Just
and just let it get super offensive. Fuck
yeah,
it, bro.
Just
enjoy it for what it is. It's entertainment.
Be some crazy motherfucker.
It would be, bro.
Mm-hmm.
You just walking back down and like, the motherfucker might be in there. Hey, man, I'm going to shuffle this goddamn hay out the barn. And goddamn nigga boy just come back there like, man, I'm going to see what this motherfucker about to do. And you just catch that motherfucker fucking a pig or some shit. You know what I mean?
I thought you were going to shuffle out some
shit. Goddamn, leave me alone, man. Goddamn, leave me alone, man.
I'm sick
of your ass. I've been hearing that goddamn hippity-bop all goddamn night.
I said, you like pig pussy.
You been snorting cocaine. I ain't said nothing about you doing that shit, man.
Fuck. Because you over there on
you
your
You out here fucking all these fat white bitches, man. It's all the goddamn same
shit. They give me all the money.
After I'm finished, I'm going to slaughter this motherfucker. We're going to have some bacon and ribs.
Hell nah, don't nut in that motherfucker.
That'd be some fucked up shit, dog. Like, man, what the
nut
hell?
Nut of the pig, nigga.
Oh,
God,
Lord.
That motherfucker
mercy,
defeated
boy.
The people. Filthy motherfucker. Dang, man.
That'd be crazy, bro. Damn, bro. But do you mind racism, bro? That don't hurt people?
Hey, man.
Or is it entertaining? Do you think it's bad as it? No, hold on. Let me ask a better question. That shit sounds stupid.
Yeah.
Do you think shit is it? Just because you may not like a group of people, is it always considered racism though?
My whole thing on the whole racism shit is...
Somebody asked me that while I'm asking.
Yeah. Is that, bruh, one, it is what it is. Whenever I say that, I ain't saying it in a simple way.
Nah, I get
it. When I say it is what it is, bro, because to force some shit is crazy. Like, to sit right here whenever they force, you know, the end of segregation or whatnot, like you forcing these kids over here, you putting them in a situation where people don't like them. You force, that's an experiment. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Because, bro, what has that done? Because most schools now, you got black schools, you got white schools. People hang around, they hang around. And it's like, if you gravitate toward white people, cool. And yeah, opposite way, the same, vice versa. Like, it's cool, but it's just like, bro, niggas really, people ain't got, people really in their own daily life, bro.
They really ain't don't fuck with
yeah,
that.
Yeah, ain't, like man, that. You, man.
Yeah, you ain't people, really fucking
people circles
that
ain't that big anyway.
Yeah. You know, you're I not, seen that shit downtown. I seen them folk down there by the Capitol building. You know what I mean? If you would have seen this shit on the news, you would have thought something was really happening down there. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
You know, I really think they do that shit to promote goddamn hatred, bro. And they were down there with their guns and shit. You
yeah.
know what I mean?
Yeah.
And it just like their little street. And it only wasn't nothing but like 10 of them, bro.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, yeah. man, why the news gonna try to blow this shit up?
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Making people being filled. And that's really why I think they promote that shit, though, bro.
Yeah, they got reason. It. Because, bro, like, from half the stuff they be saying on TV, bro, then you go out into the world and you don't experience none of it.
I mean, I didn't experience
something. No. Like, with this shit they talking about with the masks. Like, I'm talking about shit like this. Yeah, like, they're talking about how, boom, they're mandatory.
People going crazy and shit.
Yeah,
checking
mandatory.
And shit like
yeah, that. And then you go out. It
nobody
ain't that.
Nobody be stunning that shit like
yeah,
that.
And then you go places, like, people ain't got their mask mm-hmm. on, but they'll be, like, I went places, literally, like, people like, yeah, you got to have a mask on. You ain't got to wear it once you get in here, but you got to have it to
you
come through
have
the door.
Mm-hmm.
Like, that shit weird to me. It's like we halfway, it's like, that's why it's like, I don't believe, not saying I don't believe in the COVID, but it's just like, that wishy-washy
I
shit.
I wish motherfucker be real and be like, look, we made the shit, y'all. Yeah, we on number 19. The other 18 wasn't strong. We fucked up, let this one get loose. You know what I mean? My bad. You know what I'm saying? Because they making this shit seem like it just came from in the goddamn world, bro.
China.
Man, bro. That shit.
Niggas gonna
everywhere.
Miss Trump.
Hell no. Nah. Niggas ain't missing Trump, nigga.
Niggas gonna miss Trump.
I think, for real, I think people,
gonna miss
a lot of
antics.
People, smart enough to know now that no matter who the fucking president, bro, same shit, bro. Some shit gonna be bad. They really can't change shit, bro.
Damn, they fucking accomplished the goal.
Getting the guns and shit like that?
No.
What goal?
They brung it. They was able to shake up the ship and then bring it back to reality.
Mm-hmm. What you mean by
like,
that?
Like, they showed us change.
Mm-hmm.
They showed us change and what it looked like.
Yeah.
Let me see.
They showed change and what it looked like.
Yeah.
Change for the better or change for the worse?
Hold on for a second.
You good?
Hello?
Hey, David?
Yes. Yes, I sent everything over to the city manager Sylvia.
Oh, okay.
I can send you the link as well.
Oh no, she may need to approve it, so I'm okay with if you've already sent it to her.
Yeah, I sent everything over there, the invoice as well.
Okay. All right, I'll send her over.
Do you know anybody from this 509 number? That's your number. This is your number, the 509?
No, that's not my number.
Oh. Okay.
Yeah, so, let me just send her an email message real quick and I'll copy you. Well, you know what? You send me the link, just in case.
All right, I'll do that right now.
Not in case, but if you'll send it to me, I appreciate that.
I know. Because it's on YouTube. Yeah, it's on City of Morrow YouTube page. Both of them are on there.
You have reached the voicemail box.
I was in the middle of doing a recording, so I had to call you back.
Hey, bro, I'm going to be there in about 10 minutes, bro.
I'll try to see if I can find it.
All right. I just got through eating. Okay, bro. All right, I'll be there in about 10, 15 minutes. All right, yeah.
What were you just talking about, bro?
You telling me about how we seen real change. Mm. They showed it to us. What kind of change they showed up, bro?
I'm going to say the illusion of change. You know what I'm saying? They gave us one, a black president. You know what I'm saying? To where then you come back. That's for the black people. Then you come back for the white people, the far whatever, right people.
Yeah.
And you get them somebody extreme as Trump. But what Trump did was he took the veil off everybody's eyes. And he let it to where people understood to where you can goddamn get shit. You know what I'm saying? But it came at a cost. Like, it was a lot of rift in between that.
What you think he showed people they can get?
Like, you can get your own shit. It was a lot of entrepreneurs that was birthed.
You
know what I'm saying? Hell yeah, just nigga didn't know. They knew they had to get their own.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying?
I don't think that had nothing to do with Trump. I just think that had something to do with the situation that people was placed in.
No, bro, he started showing people shit.
Like what?
Hey, bro, like, just like the taxes and shit like that, he started doing a lot of shit that helped businesses.
Mm-hmm.
And then you got damn, you know what I'm saying? But that shook up everything, because it's like now, you know, you had Obama, you had the people that was loving Obama, black people, then you got these far white, whatever these strong, strong supremacist white people. They loving Trump, and everybody got damn, it seemed like, you know, you got the black people got their president, we happy. Then the white people got their president, they happy. But it's shaking up the world. It's Donald Trump shaking shit up so much because he's such an original that it's like, hey, bro, this nigga ain't got damn planning rules. We thought he was going to be good, but he ain't planning rules. This nigga don't even want to listen to us.
Yeah.
Get this crack up out of here.
Boom. I think he most definitely had his own.
And then you bring it back with Joe Biden, a libertarian, straight liberal. Like he like socialist type of guy. You know what I'm saying? Want everything to be cool, so you got them. This the goddamn. Come on, yeah, come on, baby. Yeah, it's okay. We've been through a lot.
Peace, right?
Yeah, we've been through a lot. Mm. Come on, get it back in that trap. Get them arms back around. So that was this here for Biden.
I don't fuck with none of them. Everybody know that about me, though.
Yeah.
Fuck all of them, bro. I don't feel
like
I'm
just saying, like, that's what I say about us people, though. Like, that shit just ain't even about that. It's just about with the game. Like I said, I just seen it.
But what's
like,
the point, bro? You know what I mean?
Shit, it's almost control.
Like a joke at that point. It's almost like a joke at that point, bro. You know what I'm saying? Like, really, whatever. Jonas, hey baby, girl, you're looking so pretty. Come here, give me some love. Look at you. Come here, girl. Yeah. Hey, baby. Hey, I like your hair. How you doing?
What you been eating?
It's all on your face, huh?
What is it, chocolate?
You got some chocolate?
Lipstick.
Now you got on lipstick. What's up, now?
Hey.
How you doing, y'all? Right?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I got stuff on my hand.
You do, don't you? What you got on there? What is it?
You say nothing.
It's got to be some of some dirt.
Mm-hmm. I got dream home.
You got dream house?
Mm-hmm.
You do?
Yeah.
What color it is?
It is blue.
It's blue.
Uh-huh, that's my favorite color. He has a car.
He do? Uh-huh. Who got a car?
Dreamy.
Uh-huh. Mm. How you know he got a car?
I like his car.
You do? What kind is it? What color is it? Is that one blue?
It's not blue.
It's not? Oh, okay.
It's red.
It is red.
But it's red. I'll go see him.
You are?
Uh-huh.
When you gonna go see him?
He in there. She's about to fish.
That's what she's talking about, bro.
Yeah, Dreamy.
Go ahead. Go see it then. That's the name of the fish. All right, baby. I'll see you later.
Mommy.
She got bad, bro.
Yep.
Was headed to Walmart, but then she was like, this is my dad,
studio.
And then I said,
that's awesome, man.
Then she started
trying
to, she
shouldn't
pick up the phone.
All right. Janice. That's what's up. That was a nice little intermission,
bro. Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
But, bro, I think people gonna see now that they done tried it from all angles.
Mm-hmm.
They had a black president who a lot of people put faith in, that was the same color.
Yeah.
And some people that wasn't, you know what I mean? They gave the white folks their president they wanted.
Mm-hmm.
Now, this supposed to be a president for everybody.
But truly, is he for everybody?
I don't know, bro. I don't think he for nobody, bro. I don't think none of them for nobody. I think they all just playing a role.
Yeah, it's like
but at the end of the day, I think they all sit down and kick it. Laughing and joking, like, boy, that shit, that was fucked up, Trump, you wild as hell. Then Obama over there, like, hell yeah. Goddamn, I thought that you was gonna goddamn slap one of them motherfuckers. Then Biden over there, he like, watch me bring some peace
to this
shit.
They gonna piss Trump ass out, though, when they all be going to kick it, though. Shut your whole one turn having ass up.
I seen that goddamn turnip fly up on your goddamn head, Trump.
Nah, that wasn't on Trump head, that was on Pence.
That's what that was,
that Pence. Fly.
Nah, I'm talking about that goddamn, when that shit right here be flying up in the air when the wind blowing. Yeah. I seen that fly on their goddamn head. That motherfucker just living
I don't understand how they just stood right there. That's why they lost right there. Trump pissed off. Pence, you with that fucking fly.
Mm-hmm. They got them. He
we lost Pennsylvania. You lost Pennsylvania because your ass Pence.
You ain't letting that goddamn fly buzz on your goddamn head like
whole fucking time. Niggas think your house stink. How can we run a fucking nation with your house stink?
Mm-hmm. Your goddamn shit, that's that shit you put on your goddamn head.
Stiff head, told you not to wear that fucking toupee. Told you that shit was fucked up.
You should have went where I went, goddamn it. Should have went where I goddamn went. Damn. You still fucking around. The yang yang stole shit.
Shit crazy.
Fuck. Yeah, man. But that shit, I mean, bro, this shit is just like wrestling right now to me, bro.
Mm-hmm.
That's how I look at it now, bro.
Hmm?
It's like wrestling. They putting on the show for our ass, bro. And we just loving it. Donald Trump all on the internet and shit.
He pissed. His pussy hurt.
He talking big shit.
It crazy because, bro, I had said that. I say, but I want Donald Trump to lose so I can see if he really going to leave. If he, like he say,
he got to leave. He ain't got no dang on track. What's up, baby? What that is? That's Groot, ain't it?
Uh-huh.
Yeah, that's Groot. What are you doing, little dang?
Uh-huh.
You seen your fish?
Uh-huh.
Yeah, that's what's
up.
You seen the car?
I got to see he got a car. I didn't know he had a car. Now. Where he going to drive to, though?
I don't know.
Yeah, me neither, baby. I have no idea. I'm going to cook
him. I like your hair, Johnny.
I'm going to cook him.
No, you're not.
I'm just playing. I'm not
you heard me.
Cook. You heard today?
I like your hair.
Thank you.
I don't like your lipstick, though.
She ate it. It looked like she ate the little stick.
You say
like
what?
He
I do like it.
He better like
can
it.
Can I get some kisses?
No, I got wet stick.
So I can't get no kisses?
Hey, but that's fine.
I don't want no kisses anyway.
Yes, he do. Yes, he do. You can't mess up your lipstick, huh? That's right.
It's already everywhere.
Yeah, she said she can't kiss you because she got on lipstick, bro. You heard. He trying to mess up your flow in the journey. Mm-hmm. Yeah, you out here popping.
Look at him.
I see him. He do a little damn when you press that button on.
See? I'm pressing
the little
button.
Mm-hmm.
He can dance.
He can. What kind of dance he doing?
This one.
He doing the Miller Rock.
She say this one.
This one. This kind of dance. What you call that dance?
Who was that?
That head wore, that Damien wore, that Uncle Damien wore, he like that, like he been healthy.
Oh boy, look, it's all kind of.